It is not your fault if you were born poor. It is your fault if you die poor. Mentioned by Dan Pena. I thought that was a great point made. Because as I do my best to not get a headache from some of the people that I encounter that have the same freedoms, same abilities, same choices as me, but some way somehow end up with this pity party. And they spread this pity party mentality. And then it's like the flu, it just in my opinion disempowers so many people. And there's gonna be a smart ass motherfucker, little fucking cunt, that's gonna say, well, why aren't you, are you a millionaire already? No. Nope. But I'm also not saying, oh man, I'm broke, I'm not as successful because of the patriarchy, because of racism, because of Trump, of the government. Help, help. I'll say that I haven't been the most effective with the use of my capitalist tools. But I know that what it's going to need to take to be successful and the caffeine's kicking in now. Getting the caffeine jitters. Every job that I've had, every career that I've had, I marinate on both for motivation to keep on going, because when I think about the fucking shitty people that I had to work with at jobs, my little tiny paychecks for hours and hours of my time, and I deserve that amount because that's what I was providing to the market, that's what value I was bringing to the market. And I understand that I was learning about capitalism, about sales, customer service, SKUs, logistics, and other things. And I also think, you know what, enough of that. It's time for me to do this with my brand, my name. And here we are. I need I could come at you as a fucking Disney brand. I could come at you as a fucking Death Wish movie series. I should check if there's any Death Wish movies on YouTube. Again, I like that that series of movies because it showed the what's out there in America, man. Not just in the world, third world countries, but in America. And I even think subliminally. It tells me to pinch your pennies, save up to move into a fucking gated community, walled up community, when possible. So there's less of that fucking sort of less of those savages around, whereas Hillary Clinton would call them super predators, but just plain out fucking lowlives. We come in all colors, both sexes, or in some cases all 50 types of sexes that have been that are known to exist now. No, there's only two sexes. Maybe I'll scoop up the head here a bit for this piece. Should I put this line here for the hair? I think I will. And that's why I keep on drawing, keep on talking shit, keep on reading. And Dan Penny has a, he's a bit against reading because it makes a great point when he says that a lot of people read as a form of procrastination instead of pulling the trigger and doing their own business deals. Me, I've got hundreds of clients right now that buy my stuff, my products, or my services. Should make the eyebrows, what's this called, the bag under the eyelid? And it's a... it's a refreshing feeling when you get when you make money off of you being you. And again, at this moment now, I'm just... I'm not just. I am... I should put the veins in the eyes. Focus on expanding my collection. Maybe I'll put a... maybe a torch here. Also, I can't be bragging about things that I plan on doing, because that'd be corny and lame. I don't know what this is, but it's holding whatever the hell the fire is, whatever it's on fire in here.